Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common BMW S55 engine problems. The BMW S55 is a 3-liter twin-turbocharged inline-six featured in a number of BMW M models, including the M2 Competition, M3, and BMW M4. The S55 offers anywhere from 405 up to 493 horsepower and 410 to 443 foot-pounds of torque. Now, the S55 is based very closely on the BMW N55 engine. BMW M simply made a number of updates essentially to a base N55. It still is quite a different engine from just the standard N55. Roughly 25% of the components on the BMW S55 were completely new developments compared to the N55. And many of those remaining 75% of components that were carried over from the N55 were still tweaked or changed to handle the additional stresses and power output of the S55. BMW M engine. Speaking of the N55, BMW went through some tougher times with some of their earlier turbo engines, especially the BMW N54, and even the N55 had a number of reliability issues. And even though the S55 is based on the N55, so far the S55 seems to be a little bit more reliable even than the N55 engine. But ultimately, the S55 was kind of a major turning point for BMW in terms of reliability, especially looking at their newer engines nowadays, the B48, B58, and S58, which are all incredibly reliable engines. The S55 was kind of at the forefront of that major change in BMW's direction with reliability. So ultimately, this is still a great engine, but it does suffer from a number of common problems. So with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common problems with the BMW S55. Number one on the list, we have the crank hub. Now I want to point out immediately that the crank hub is an issue that has been largely blown out of proportion on the S55 M engines. There were some failures in the early days, and it led some people to panic and believe that this was a super common and devastating issue for the engine. However, it turns out that crank hub issues, or spun crank hubs in particular, affect a very, very small percentage of these S55 engines. When it comes to the crank hub, it isn't an ideal design for the S55. The crank hub design was a little bit antiquated and probably not quite up to the challenge of handling the much quicker revs and higher power of the S55, especially when tuned and modified with the dual clutch transmission. So ultimately, it's something to be aware of. However, it's not something I would worry about or really stress too much about unless you are planning on pushing 600-700 plus wheel horsepower, especially on upgraded turbos. When you get to that point anyway, you're at a point where it's probably worth starting to consider building the engine or at least doing a couple of these reliability upgrades. So in the grand scheme, it is something to potentially address if you are looking to build a very powerful S55. But in stock form, or even just with light modifications on these stock turbochargers, it's really a low percentage, likely less than 1% of vehicles that are affected by spun crank hubs. Just something worth pointing out, since if the crank hub does spin, that will require a new crank hub as well as retiming the engine, which can be expensive, and in very, very rare worst case scenarios, the timing can jump enough and allow pistons and valves to contact each other and essentially either destroy the engine or result in very, very expensive repair bills. Moving on to our second common problem, we have top mount intercooler failure, or specifically the intercooler leaking. It appears that this has become more and more common as some of these S55s have approached that 8 to 10 year old ballpark, and especially 80,000 plus miles. Now, what ultimately happens is the intercooler fails internally and begins leaking coolant into the intake manifold and ultimately into the cylinders of the engine, where it's burned off, and that will often produce a white smoke from the exhaust. And then, of course, another common symptom to look out for is simply low coolant in the secondary tank that is responsible for powering the air to water intercooler system. So if you're noticing smoke from the exhaust and low coolant in your intercooler expansion tank, then that's something to consider. Potentially you have an intercooler failure internally. Now, if you're looking to tune and upgrade your S55 in the first place, this is really a pretty minor issue. The factory intercooler is very efficient, and we usually don't recommend upgrading that until 600 plus wheel horsepower, as the cooling system is very capable on stock turbos and lower boost. But still, if you do run into the failure, it won't hurt to upgrade there are plenty of long-term solutions, very high-quality aftermarket intercoolers that will not only offer some performance benefits, but also offer better long-term reliability for the S55. Moving on to our third and final issue, lumped a few things together here with oil and coolant leaks. The S55, especially as it gets older, some of these standard BMW problems are starting to become a little bit more common on the S55. That includes things like the coolant hoses, water pump, coolant expansion tank, valve cover, gasket, oil leaks, oil pan gasket leaks, and leaks from the oil filter housing. As these S55s get into that 80 to 120,000 plus mile ballpark, it's likely that many of these engines will start running into at least one or two of the issues from that list, resulting in some form of oil or coolant leaks. Now, fortunately, these issues have seemed a lot less common on the S55 as compared to engines like the N54 and N55. However, that might have something to do with the fact that many N54s and N55s are probably driven more on an annual basis. And so part of the reason in the earlier days that these leaks seem less common could just be the fact that these engines weren't seeing the road as much and accumulating mileage quite as quickly. So anyway, ultimately something to be on the lookout for as these engines get older and older. They generally start to run into a few of those common BMW problems. So nothing serious, not really any design flaws or anything to hold against the S55. It's not even just BMW. Tons of engines are prone to various cooling issues, oil leaks, coolant leaks, etc. as they get to that 8 to 10 year mark at 100,000 plus miles. Rubber parts, plastic parts, anything like O-ring seals, gaskets, coolant hoses, those types of components simply tend to become brittle and degrade with age and mileage. Just something to consider if you are looking to pick one up, especially one that might be a little older and have some higher mileage on it. So in summary of BMW S55 common problems, overall, I would say this engine offers good reliability. It's not the most reliable engine out there, but it's certainly far from the least reliable engine, and that's especially true comparing it to, again, engines like the N54. When BMW was first getting into turbocharged direct injected engines, the S55 has come a long way since the early days of BMW building these engines, and ultimately, again, a lot of the issues really aren't anything too concerning. There's the crank hub issue that was largely blown out of proportion and really doesn't affect many vehicles. Then there are the intercooler problems, which has become more common with age and mileage on these S55s, but still a minor issue in the grand scheme, and that's especially true if you're planning to tune and modify your S55, then upgrading that intercooler isn't a bad idea anyway. And then lastly, again, the engine is prone to a couple of those standard BMW issues, but really nothing too severe or costly in the grand scheme. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more. Thanks, everyone.